Hello students, we are going through grammar section, and in that grammar section there is our topic tense. We have already discussed present tense, its four forms, past tense, its four forms, and we are going through future tense. In the last lecture we have gone through simple future tense and future continuous tense. Simple future tense denote the action that is yet to happen, and future continuous tense shows the action that will be going on at a point of time in future. Now the third form of the future tense that is written here, future perfect tense. We have already written the title future perfect tense. This is the third form of the future tense. Okay, see what is the use of this future perfect tense. This tense shows the action. This tense shows the action that will be completed at a point of time in future. See what is written here. The difference between future continuous tense and future perfect tense. Future continuous tense denote the action that will be going on. Okay, and here this tense, future perfect tense, denote the action that will be completed at a point of time in future. Okay, its meaning is that this action shows us that it will be completed at a point of time in future, will be completed. Okay, that is not completed. If the action is completed at this time, that is present perfect tense. If the action was completed at a point of time in past, that time, that is past perfect tense. And here the action that will be completed, ji purna zhaleli asel kadhi, at a particular point of time in future, bhavishyakalat ekadya tharavik velela ekadi kriya purn zhaleli asel asu sangnyasathi ha tense vaparla jato. Right, now we have to discuss its structure. Okay, the structure is subject plus shall oblique will plus have plus V3 plus object etc. last full stop. This structure is written. At first there is subject, so this is assertive sentence, and at last there is full stop. After subject I and we have to use shall, and except I and we have to use will. After shall oblique will, there is have work here as a V1, and V3 is used here. Now we have to discuss, after shall oblique will, there is V1, means this is future tense. Yes, shall oblique will plus V1 is a future tense, and V3 shows perfect action. V3 shows perfect action, and shall oblique will plus V1 shows future time. So this tense has given, this structure has given the name future perfect tense, because shall oblique will plus V1 shows future time, and V3 shows perfect action. Now the point is that why do we use have here? Why there is not has? Okay, why there is not be. Okay, in future continuous tense we have used be as a V1, and in this future perfect we are using have, not a has. What is the reason? The reason is that we have already discussed, after shall oblique will we have to use V1. Okay, yes. And you know that in present perfect, in past perfect, we have discussed before verb third, there should be the form of have. There should be the form of have. We have used after has, after have, and after had. What is used? Verb third. Okay. After the form of have, we can use verb third. Okay. So we are using here verb third, and before verb third we have to place the form of have. And what is the first form of have? That is this have. Has is the yes form that is not used here, because after shall oblique will there should be verb one. Has is not a verb one. Then had is not also a verb one, just have is the V1, and that have can be placed after shall oblique will as a V1. Okay, and before, see there, and after have we can use verb third, that is given here. See, now we have to take some examples of this tense. We have already discussed this tense is used to show the action that will be completed at a point of time in future. See here, the example first, I shall have arranged a birthday party, full stop. I shall have arranged a birthday party. What is the meaning? I shall have arranged. Me arrange keleli asel. Kay arrange keleli asel? A birthday party. Me arrange keleli asel. Okay. Here I is subject. Shall plus have plus V3. This is future perfect tense, and a birthday party is a object. Shall plus have plus V3 shows future perfect tense. What is its meaning? Meaning is that I shall have arranged a birthday party. Me birthday party arrange keleli asel. Keleli asel manje in future. Okay, the birthday party will be arranged. Je arrange zaleli asel kadi in future te darshavta. Next example, she will have written, she will have written a letter to her mother in next week. She will have written a letter. What is the meaning? Tina ek patra purcha atvadyat ticha aai sati lihilela asel. Lihilela asel. Okay, it means she will have completed. What will have completed? She will have completed a letter of writing. Okay. She will have completed a letter in writing to her mother in the next week. Here will plus have plus V3 shows future perfect tense. Next example, Ajay will have changed his address, his residential a dress. In next month. See what is written. Ajay will have changed. It means here Ajay is a third person singular subject. After this there is will plus have plus V3. Will plus have future tense and V3 means perfect. This is future perfect. Ajay will have changed his residential address in next month. Okay, in the next month he will have completed the work. What work? Changing of the residential address. Okay, he will have completed, he will have changed his residential address in next month. This is the example. Next example, see here. Birds will have flown away in March month. See what is written. Birds will have flown away. Here bird subject, will plus have plus V3 future perfect tense. Birds will have flown away in March month. Birds March month madhe udun dur udun gelele astil. It means the action will have completed, right? Okay, these type of the examples are done in this tense with the help of this structure. The structure is subject plus shall oblique will plus have plus V3, right? Now we should turn towards the last form of the future tense, that is future perfect continuous tense. We should clear this at first. The last form of the future tense we are going to discuss, that is future perfect continuous tense. You know the present tense, its fourth form, present perfect continuous tense. Past tense, its fourth form, past perfect continuous tense. And now likewise, present tense and past tense, there is the last form of the future tense, that is future perfect continuous tense. See here, we should write the title, the fourth form, future perfect continuous tense. We should underline the title, future perfect continuous tense. Okay, we have already discussed present perfect continuous tense denote the action that is started from past, partly completed in present, but continue. And in past perfect continuous tense, we have discussed the action that was started from past, completed in past, but continued. And here in future perfect continuous tense, this tense denotes the action that will be completed, at a point of time for some duration, but will continue. See here what is written. This tense denotes the action that will be completed at a point of time for some duration. ओके द ऍक्शन विल बी कम्प्लीटेड, पूर्ण झालेली असेल, ॲट ए पॉइंट ऑफ टाईम, म्हणजे एखाद्या ठराविक वेळेला ॲक्शन पूर्ण झालेली असेल, फॉर सम ड्युरेशन, काही कालावधीसाठी पूर्ण झालेली असेल, बट परंतु विल कंटिन्यू, ते पुढे चालू असेल. ओके, फॉर एक्झाम्पल इन फ्युचर टेन्स, सी हियर दिस इज प्रेझेंट अँड हियर फ्युचर टेन्स. ओके, नाऊ टुडे इज मंडे, नेक्स्ट इज ट्यूजडे, देन वेन्सडे. ओके, द ॲक्शन विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम फ्युचर, ओके, अँड विल कम्प्लीट हियर. ओके, द ॲक्शन विल कम्प्लीट फॉर अ पर्टिक्युलर पॉइंट ऑफ टाईम, द पर्टिक्युलर पॉइंट ऑफ टाईम इज गिवन वेन्सडे. ओके, द ॲक्शन विल कम्प्लीट फॉर अ पर्टिक्युलर ड्युरेशन ऑन वेन्सडे बट विल कंटिन्यू, राईट. द ॲक्शन विल बी कम्प्लीटेड ॲट अ पॉइंट ऑफ टाईम. ओके, फॉर एक्झाम्पल द ॲक्शन, ओके, द ॲक्शन ऑफ रिडिंग अ नॉवेल विल बी कम्प्लीटेड ऑन धिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाईम, दॅट इज ऑन वेन्सडे, बट इट विल कंटिन्यू. लाईक धिस वी कॅन एक्सप्लेन. नाऊ वी हॅव टू डिस्कस द स्ट्रक्चर दॅट इज यूज्ड टू शो धिस टेन्स. द स्ट्रक्चर इज सब्जेक्ट प्लस शाल ऑब्लिक विल प्लस हॅव प्लस बीन प्लस वी फोर. वी हॅव टू राईट द स्ट्रक्चर, सब्जेक्ट प्लस शाल ऑब्लिक विल प्लस हॅव प्लस बीन प्लस वी फोर प्लस ऑब्जेक्ट एक्सेट्रा अँड लास्ट फुल स्टॉप. दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर. दिस स्ट्रक्चर शोज फ्युचर परफेक्ट कंटिन्युअस टेन्स. वॉट इज यूज्ड हियर? आफ्टर सब्जेक्ट देर इज शाल ऑब्लिक विल. ओके, अँड आफ्टर शाल ऑब्लिक विल वी हॅव टू प्लेस व्ही वन, हॅव वर्क हियर ॲज अ व्ही वन, देन बीन वर्क्स ॲज अ व्ही थ्री, मीन्स टू मेक द परफेक्ट ॲक्शन, अँड व्ही फोर वर्क हियर ॲज अ कंटिन्युअस. सी हियर फ्युचर शाल ऑब्लिक विल प्लस व्ही वन इज द फ्युचर टेन्स, देन बीन शोज परफेक्ट ॲक्शन अँड व्ही फोर शोज कंटिन्युअस ॲक्शन. सो देर आर टू ॲक्शन्स. शाल ऑब्लिक विल प्लस हॅव इज यूज्ड बिकॉज हॅव कॅन बी प्लेस्ड बिफोर वर्ब थर्ड इन द टेन्स. सो हॅव इज यूज्ड अँड देर इज नीड टू प्लेस व्ही वन आफ्टर शाल ऑब्लिक विल. सो हॅव वर्क हियर फॉर टू रूल्स. आफ्टर शाल ऑब्लिक विल देअर शुड बी व्ही वन, हॅव इज वर्किंग हियर ॲज अ व्ही वन, अँड बिफोर वर्ब थर्ड देअर शुड बी द फॉर्म ऑफ हॅव. सो हॅव इज यूज्ड हियर. ओके, शाल ऑब्लिक विल प्लस हॅव इज द फ्युचर टाईम, देन बीन शोज परफेक्ट ॲक्शन अँड व्ही फोर शोज कंटिन्युअस ॲक्शन. नाऊ द एक्झाम्पल. Example is, I shall have been teaching English. I shall have been teaching English for 10 years in next month. What is written here? I is a subject, shall plus have plus been plus V4. Here, shall plus have plus been plus V4 shows future perfect continuous tense. I shall have been teaching English. म्हणजे मी इंग्लिश शिकवत आलेलो असेन. For 10 years, for some duration, कालावधीसाठी, म्हणजेच कोणत्या? फॉर 10 इयर्स इन नेक्स्ट मंथ, पुढच्या मंथमध्ये, म्हणजे इन फ्युचर. ओके, इन फ्युचर द ॲक्शन विल हॅव कम्प्लीटेड. See here, the example is written. In future tense, in next month is for future to us. In next month, the action will have been completed. See here, shall have been teaching. The action will have been completed for 10 years means this is the duration for 10 years that is written here. Me पुढच्या महिन्यामध्ये 10 वर्षांसाठी इंग्लिश शिकवत आलेलो असेन अशा पद्धतीचे एग्जांपल बनतं. नेक्स्ट नंबर 2 सीमा विल हैव बीन रीडिंग अ नॉवेल फॉर 4 वीक्स in next on next Monday. See, this is the example written here. Seema will have been reading. Where is the tense? Will plus have plus been plus V4, that is the future perfect continuous tense. Seema will have been reading a novel for 4 weeks. Okay, Seema's work, Seema's action of reading a novel will be completed at a point of time is given, okay, on next Monday for some duration is given for 4 weeks, okay, but it will continue reading. V4 shows continuous action, right? The will be completed means will have been, okay, future perfect tense, will have been future perfect, and then the action will continue, that is reading, okay, reading shows the continuous action. Seema will have been reading a novel for 4 weeks on next Monday. This is the example written here. Now the last example. Teachers will have been teaching us. Teachers will have been teaching us for 9 months in next week. See here, the example is written. Teachers will have been teaching. Teachers शिकवत आलेले असतील. कुणाला? Us. आपल्याला शिकवत आलेले असतील for 9 months. किती महिन्यासाठी? 9 months साठी. पण कधी? In next week. Okay, that is written here. Now we have covered all the forms of tense. We have covered present tense, its 4 forms, past tense, its 4 forms with structure examples, and future tense with its 4 forms. We have covered the 12 forms of the tenses here. Now we have to stop, okay? The remaining part will be in the next lecture. Okay, thank you.